kidding.
That was shit!
Do it again like a bitch.
Do it again
exactly the same way.
Oh, no.
Fiddling with his hair.
Stop it.
Just do it. Oh, he's fiddling. Hi, guys. So it's final vlog time. Sorry we haven't done as many as I said we would. We've just been really, really busy. We're now recording the last bits and pieces, so we're on final bits of backing vocals and all the other stuff. This album isn't just going to be kind of like the classic sort of, you know, 12 tracks, usual business. It's going to be a bit more, so stay tuned for whatever that is, and we put up a track listing and all that. So I'm pretty sad that we're coming to the end of our trip. America's been pretty cool. I do miss England a bit. I mean, everyone's miserable in England. And I am a bit too, so I guess I kind of fit in. But there's this kind of like almost false enthusiasm over here. Everyone is kind of really, really nice, and you kind of, as a cynic, you kind of, what's your game, you know? So I miss that. I miss the honesty of England. So I'll be.
That again.
A little bit of Lawrence there. So what else have we been up to? Something very American, 4th of July. We were lucky enough to be here when that all happened, which was really cool. It's like a big holiday over here. Obviously it's Independence Day, so as English people we were a bit out of place, like, because it was them celebrating their independence from the English. So we were kind of, well, we were very welcome, I don't know what I'm talking about, but yeah, it was really cool. The best part of it was one of Will's friends, Keith, took us way out, kind of somewhere in the sticks outside of Seattle, and with an array of weapons. I mean, this guy had like an armory. I mean, he even brought a machete for some reason. I don't know why, he just had one. So he had guns, lots of guns. He had two, what are they called? Glocks, I don't know, two AR-15s, like semi-automatic machine guns, and a pump-action shotgun. So we basically spent a whole morning on the 4th of July being about as American as you can be, on this firing range in the middle of nowhere, just like shooting off weapons. Drew was particularly badass. He was like, didn't expect it. He just let rip. Give Drew a machine gun. It's over. So, kind of lucky that guns aren't legal in England, otherwise you may go on some kind of rampage. But yeah, that was really cool. And then later on that day, Will took us around some of his families, and we had like a barbecue, so like loads of American food. I don't know if you saw, I posted a picture of like this Union Jack, a star, the American flag, but a cake, which was amazing. I had all sorts. What is it? They had some of my new favorite food. They had like this pulled chicken, kind of like in barbecue sauce. And they had that like on top of hot dogs. Yeah, so it was like a hot dog. It was like beef, it wasn't even pork. It was about this big. And they had like a load of mustard and then like pulled barbecue chicken on the top and cheese in this massive bun. So I was enjoying it. And then we went to see the fireworks, which was really cool. probably the longest fireworks display I've ever seen in my life. I've seen a few kind of when I was home and kind of last, what, they last like 10 minutes? I swear this one went on for like half an hour at least. And like it stopped and everyone started to go and then it started again. Everyone was like, what are we doing? But yeah, no, that was really cool. So yeah, on the food subject, also, whilst I remember, I tried a corn dog. Now, if you're not familiar with what a corn dog is, it's a sausage on a stick in kind of donut batter meat, like deep fried, no, not batter meat, like donut batter, deep fried. And they're the most gloriously horrible thing I've ever had in my entire life. And they're quite nice, but I had like one and I felt ill, so. This morning we went into Seattle, the city, or Seattle, terrible pronunciation, which was like the first time I've actually been in since we've been here, because we've literally been holed up in Will's place, just recording. So we just went into the actual town, and Will like wouldn't tell us where we were going, classically, so we rolled up at Kurt Cobain, or was Kurt Cobain's house, which was pretty cool, and kind of walked up, it's like big, it's gated off, and big house, kind of like on the sort of waterfront. Just beside it, there's like a bench where all the fans have kind of written like messages to him, kind of after he died. So that was a pretty eerie experience, a bit of like a rock and roll pilgrimage, which was cool.
Where is this, Shane?
This is Seattle.
Where's this specifically?
Well, it's like Kurt Cobain's house.
Well, it's obviously not his house anymore.
And then we went into the town and we visited the market, which was pretty cool. There's like, in Seattle, there's this underground and above ground market. They do this thing called throwing the fish. So there's like all these fishmongers from the port and they're, I don't know, they just sell fish and they throw them around. But yeah, so we went there and Will sent me to get some donuts. And literally there was like a health food stand and a donut stand in this market, and the health food stand had no one there. They were giving away free apple, and the donut stand was just like, the queue was round the corner. Felt a little bit sorry for the lady at the health food stand, but yeah, very popular. So we had some full on American donuts that were just sprinkled with icing sugar. Just sounds like my whole trip has just been about food, really. I think that's Will's fault. He's literally taken me on like a journey of all his favourite food joints, which just happened to be in Seattle and the USA. Yeah, that was really cool. I mean, the actual city, we didn't find Frasier, unfortunately. I'm told that he spends some time in Boston, so I'll have to go there as well and try and get him. But yeah, it's a really nice place. Didn't see the Space Needle either, which was a shame. That's about it, really. For our shenanigans, we're kind of wrapping up here, and then literally 2 days' time we're going to be flying home, and then the next day we've got a bunch of shows. So for anyone in the UK that's watching, we will be playing in Wolverhampton and Bristol and Tunbridge Wells and Rugby and Wrexham. Yes, I remembered. Next week. So come see us play. Welcome us home and we'll have a good time. I'll see you guys soon. Right. Bye.
Yeah. 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 Yay! Ooh. I pressed the wrong button.
Okay, ready?
Yeah, it's coming. Jesus.